All right, so I need to accept it right now. It's definitely going to be triggered here, for sure. There's a Wallywog. Okay, come on, come on, come on, come on. It's definitely going to be triggered here. It's just a question of when. Will you live? Okay, you will. Cool. Take him back. Alright, that's down. More Bulbmen. Oh, hello. Take them out real quick. Come on, come on, come on. Now, the Bulbmen mother is actually really ferocious. She will kill Pikmin. I would dare say she's one of the harder enemies of the game. Like, she's really terrifying. Like, look at her guzzle down Pikmin. I mean, she took down one, but she will mess them up. Yeah, yeah, she took down so many. In fact, we had a net gain of one Pikmin because of that. Okay, carry that back. Okay, that's not fair. That also doesn't work. I lost most of my leaves, which is not good. Ugh. That is not possible. You can't blow through walls. That is not... Oh my goodness, I'm just going to avoid that. You can't blow through walls. That doesn't work. That's not physics. You literally cannot do that. It's impossible. You guys can really tell I'm getting flustered. Okay, you take care of that. Okay, you guys can't do anything. Okay, kill this quickly as possible. There are a lot of dead ends, which will actually help me out a lot here. Okay, kill it. Neat. There actually is a treasure inside this. We'll take down... We need to go here anyway. You can take care of this. And otherwise, Louie, you go back to base with this. Alright, good. Oh, I thought they were done. Not quite, though. Oh, hey. You guys can take that out, just real quick. Take it down, take it down. Take this down. Oh, I'm not even talking about things that aren't happening in the game. Although there is one thing I can talk about. There's actually a channel that I would like to recommend here. I don't normally do this, but I'm probably going to be using their music in this anyway. No! Run! Okay, I just realized what kind of Dweevil I'm messing with here. Yeah, take the enemy. There you go. You can do that. I'm cool with that. But you are one of the more dangerous Dweevils of the game. Actually, you are the most dangerous Dweevil in the game. Alright, so you can deal with that. Dan, I got so scared there that the 5-minute timer is up. But I would like to recommend channel here, as I was saying. There is a guy that I watch, actually pretty frequently. His name is Scruffy. And he has some really good content, especially because it is Pikmin-oriented content. And that's kind of rare. Okay, I need to go in there. He has Pikmin-oriented content. And, like I said, pretty rare for that to happen. But specifically, he has a really disturbing remix of this theme. Really? Oh, that's dumb. Oh, that's so unfair. I can't deal with that. My only hope is that it's going to go over the fence. That's not possible to deal with, and I'm burning time. And it's a sure thing now that the threat is going to come in here. But yeah, he has a really good remix of this cave's theme that you should really check out. I'll leave a link in the description or even on screen. It's really good, but I'm probably going to be using that music. I believe he said it's okay. Not to me specifically, but he said it's fine if you credit him. Oh, I can't deal with that. That's so stupid. Okay, are there any other treasures over here, though? None? Alright. Well, okay. That's good then, I guess. Even though the enemy is about to spawn. Come on! Alright, let's go see if I can deal with that thing. What are you even doing? Oh, they're trying to get that guy. Okay, I'll just go into the cave dead end and let Louie deal with the rest. But that's so dumb. I can't. I'm probably gonna have to use a spray. Come on. Alright, just leave them right here. Right there. They should be safe. Now, Louis, I may have to use two sprays here. Unless he doesn't spray through the wall. Oh, he's going to. Yep. Okay. You just do that. Come on. Take it down. Is he not going to blow at them? Maybe they programmed that in. Well, there he is. Okay. It looks like I'm on a good track, though. That is the most frightening enemy in Nintendo Pikmin history. That is the Waterwraith. What is this? I can see it with my optical receptors, but my sensors cannot detect it. Could its physical form be anchored in another dimension? Attacking it is futile. If only we could force it to take on physical form, but in its current state... Danger, 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 danger. That is the Waterwraith. Did it kill Pikmin? No, okay. It focuses the active captain! Okay, it focuses the active captain, which is a way I can... No! No! How many did I lose? How many did I lose? Did I just lose everything? Oh, that's not a good start. It killed everything. Okay. Yeah, blow at me. It killed a good 40 Pikmin, but I'm playing it where it lies, as I said. Being chain grabbed by a stupid blowhog. I hate blowhogs. Don't kill me. Okay. It'll take a while for it to turn around. Let's kill it in the meantime. Switch over to Olimar. Bring it over to... Good. Okay. Switch back. And kill it. It will not go into dead ends, and it will always focus the active captain. So I can use that to my advantage in bringing it where I need it to go. And moving it away from the Pikmin carrying things. Alright, so at this point, I'm going to dismiss my crew. And move out into the open. It appears to be good. It's leaving me alone right now. Nope, no, 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 okay. I need to lure it away from my active member. Or from the thing that's carrying stuff back. There we go, there we go. Yeah, come on this way. There's no treasure over there, good. Okay, which way is it taking it? I can't see, I can use the map. Okay, it's carrying it that way. I haven't gone this way. Okay, there's nothing there. All right, so I can lure it this way. Come on, buddy, come on, come on. Yep, it's focusing the active member. And while it's doing that, Louis, you take the squad back. Come on, come on, come on. Back to the main group. I still need to be taking... Actually, I need to be taking enemies along the way. I just remembered. But that is... Oh, man, that was catastrophic. They paired the Dweevils with death. Oh, man. I'm losing Pikmin left and right. Once again, playing it where it lies. Come on. Go back. Go back to me. Go back to me. Come to me. Come to me. I'm down to 60 Pikmin. It's killing Pikmin along the way. Yep, come on. Come on this way. He will not go in the dead end. Olimar is fairly safe here. It took away the elemental hazard. Now, I can use Bitter Spray on it to freeze it temporarily. Come on. No, 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 no. Come to me. Come to me. Come to me. Turn around. Turn around. Turn around. Oh, boy. No, 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 no. Let's see if I can save those Bulbmen. Bulbmen, come on, come on, come on. Get out of the way. Oh, boy. Run, 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 run. Run. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Go, 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 go. Okay, Olimar didn't get hurt. Good, 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 good. Get in this hidey hole. Oh, whew, safe. All right, bring it back to base. All right. Louis, go save those Pikmin. Actually, no, enter the cave. Enter the cave. Let me check my treasure status. Oh, boy. I think we can just go. Go, go, go. Switch back to Olimar. Okay, we're good. Those Pikmin are in the path of danger here, but I should be able to leave the cave. That was catastrophic, and there's nothing I could have done about that either. I had to lure the Waterwraith away from my squad, but at the same point, I also had to keep them away from the volatile Dweevil. That was terrible, and not a good start to this cave. But thankfully, there aren't that many sublevels here. But still, I lost 40 Pikmin. Okay, I don't know. I forget. I know there's a 5-minute timer for when the Waterwraith will spawn, but I'm not sure what the timer is for, come on, get over here. Okay, I'm not sure what the timer is for it once it has already spawned. Okay, good, there are more Boldmen. Now, Boldmen, the Boldmen Mother can harbor up to 15 Boldmen at a time, and that is, it's calculated with the number of Pikmin that I start at. So, what I can do is, well, I mean, if I lose Pikmin, then the Boldmen Mother will be there to supplement my numbers with more. So, while my actual Pikmin count, like the Pikmin count I'm leaving the cave with, will be insanely low, it's gonna... You guys said there were no bomb traps. You guys were wrong. I actually need to get this guy. There. It had a treasure in it. While my numbers are going to be fairly low, my actual count will be fine. Okay, Boldmen Mother, I need to kill her. Come on, Boldmen Mother. Go over here. I may actually just freeze her with a spray, because I have spares. Oh, there could be a volatile. And a stupid... I hate the cutscenes. I really do. I don't like the cutscenes, because it means that I don't know what's happening. Even though time freezes, it's still a nerve-wracking thing. Get him out of the way. Oh, I had to use the C-stick to get him out of danger there. There's another bomb rock. You guys told me that there would be no more of these. More bomb rocks. More bomb rocks. You guys told me. You promised me. You promised me there were no more. Actually, gonna do this because I want the Boldmen Mother's body. I was able to sneak up on her and kill her. Cool. Up to 72. That's good. How many treasures left are there? You guys told me there would be no more bomb rocks. You lied. There are so many more bomb rocks. Maybe you guys meant Wallywog traps. I think you guys meant Wallywog traps, but I would rather blame you for this than me. All right. Where is he going to spawn? And where's the cave? Oh, I need to go this way. Okay. More bomb rock traps? There are more Boldmen, at least. Will this damage the bridge? I'm not sure. I doubt it will. Nope. Will not damage the bridge. Okay, once again, I need to spread my captains out. In fact, let's go flower them, but then leave Louie there, because that will be a nice anchor for Olimar to switch to whenever the Waterwraith gets on my case. I can switch back to Louie. He'll start going towards Louie. And actually, that's not a good idea. Leave them there. And Louie, you go to a place where the Waterwraith will not harm the captain. Like here. This'll work, yeah. Okay. This should be good. Is there no treasure in there? There's no treasure in there. Does that mean that's going to be inside the Boldmen Mother? That's possible. Oh, hello. Come on, pop him. Okay, wait for that to explode, then pop him again. I lost some numbers somehow? Was that from the explosion? I think it was from the explosion. Somehow that hit Pikmin. All right. Take this down. The Boldmen Mother, I don't think, can attack Pikmin from behind that. The rest of the Pikmin, you get on that. Is that a battery? Oh, I thought that was a sprite. I'm like, that's really lazy. But no, the battery was just tilted at a weird angle. Okay, switch over to Louie. He's fine. In fact, Louie, if you could whistle... Oh, there are no Pikmin at base. Okay, that works. I was going to say he could whistle them. Just keep them out of harm's way for the Waterwraith that is inevitably coming. At least they give me some hiding places in this cave, because then I can hide out in one of those pipes, and the Waterwraith can't get to me. Okay, bring this down one more level. Come on. Nice. Okay, this time... No, I'm gonna let them kill him. Oh, there are a bunch. There are a bunch. There was no way I could have gotten out of that. There was literally no way I could have gotten out of that. I'm losing Pikmin left and right. I was supposed to be being careful. Three, okay, three there. And then five there. And then we'll go back to base, get some more, and then we should be good. Man, this was, I told you, this was the cave that I needed to be careful. Bomb rock traps. Okay, they should be fine. Well, there they are. Where is it? There it is. I saw it off screen. Okay, it should be fine. Go after the active captain, please. Why is it not going after the active captain? Does it just need to turn around? Okay. Active captain, please. Louis the active one. There he comes. Okay, I should be fine. I'm gonna go into this corner, actually. Will it be able to hit me here? We'll find out. Will it be able to hit me? Don't crush them. Oh, barely. Whew. Okay, where is that battery? No. Come after me. Don't go after them, please. Don't go after him. Oh, boy. That was close. Will it crush them? Might. It's going to. No! It killed two of them. But the other ones were safe. Okay, let's get into this corner. Get into the corner. Switch over. Switch captains. Where is he? Go after the active captain, please. Active captain. Oh, crunch into the space. Oh, that was close. All right, active captain. Go after me. We're gonna switch roles here. Come on, come here. This way. I'm the one you want. All right, now Louis, go. And he's gonna go to another corner. No, come after me. Don't turn after Louis. Don't go after Louis. Is he going for Louis? He is. Oh, boy. Crunch into the corner. Barely, okay. Now, Olimar, you go to an opposite end of the map. You go here. Go here. He can't get me here. Where is he? There he is. This is a little bit awkward because I have two treasures that I need to get. Come after me. Is he still going after me? He is. Okay. He's locked into that path. Let's go get the battery and then circle around, go get the other treasure. Take this back. Hurry. Go after me again. Or is he leaving? I think he's leaving, which means that he's going after Louis, so Louis's going to have to hide. Got 90. We're getting there. We are getting there. Proton, AA. There he is. He's going after Louis, Hide in this corner. Oh. Don't crush me. Oh, no. No. Oh, we lost three. That could have been a lot worse. Okay, go after Olimar. Please. Olimar. Go after Olimar, please. Okay, there he goes. Let's get them out of the way. Wait, what? What on earth? I don't know how they died. Okay, this is so difficult. All right, got some flowers. He's coming after Olimar. Good. Meanwhile, we'll send them down this alternate path. They can always go through a corner. Once again, my numbers are scarily low, but it's all I can do. Okay, so he's gonna have to go a really awkward path. But we should be able to get here and then distract him again. At this point, there's no reason to follow the timer. Okay, where is he going? Is he here? I don't see him. Where'd he go? Sadly, I can't see him on the map. Ah, Bomb Rock. Where'd he go? Seriously, where'd he go? Where is he? Okay, he's over there. Don't know why he's over there. Will this be enough? I doubt it will be enough. This is not a 50, this is a 20 treasure. No, it's enough. Okay, it's enough. Okay, take it back. And then Olimar. Where is he? Where is he? Where is he? Where is he? All right, it'll be Olimar's job to babysit this guy. Yep, this way. Come on. Yeah, this way. Good job. Go the long way. As I allow the treasure to circumvent going this path. Hopefully it does not go that way, although I don't think it can. If so, I should be able to Ultra Bitter Spray it, and that'll be enough to stall for time. I can Ultra Bitter Spray it, which is nice. And I'm just gonna lead this, what? Okay, he got stuck. He can't go under that gateway there. Hopefully he's still after me though. Looks like he is, okay. Still after Olimar. I think I managed to keep the situation contained. Once again, I'm down to 55 Pikmin. Remember that I only entered here with 85, so I've lost 30, which is bad, but it also means that I've lost mainly Bulbmen, which is good. So, Bulbmen are definitely expendable. They're actually a type of Pikmin, but not in the way you'd expect. They're a type of Pikmin that they are parasitic. So what they will do is they will take over the host of a Bulborb's mind, and then from there, they will take it over, sort of like a Cordyceps, and then they will take it over and they'll take it over and control its mind, like Cordyceps. There we go. Sorry, I'm really flustered with this cave and losing so many Pikmin. Okay, I think I'm on track. I think I'm on track to finish the debt. I'm at 9,900. I think I can do it. Plus, I believe this is the final sub-level. It's all come down to this. I've lost a ton of Pikmin, but it wasn't due to me playing recklessly. It was due to very unfortunate things happening. I have more Bulbmen than I have purples. Or, I mean, blues. Actually, is that true? I have 35 blues in my party. Okay, so I have 25 Bulbmen. Which, we're going to be converting all of them. Oh, that was dumb. I shouldn't have whistled him. We're going to be converting all of the Bulbmen into purples, or 10 of them. That way we'll at least have a gain of Pikmin. Okay, Bulbmen, come on. We haven't really gotten an opportunity to look at the Bulbmen. This is the final floor, so I do have that luxury. Let's look at a Bulbmen real quick. First of all, they make this really cute noise. And I'll throw a flower and a leaf. There they are. They're adorable. They're not even just downsized Bulborbs. They have a unique look of their own. They'll chew on their flower. Cute little guys. Though it is sad the circumstances that we had to get them in. These guys are orphans because we killed their mother. Even if they're possessed, it's still a separate species. Okay, we're gonna throw Leaf Bulbmen in. And then Leaf Bulbmen in here as well. And throw one of them on that. That way, at the very least, these Bulbmen can find a new life with us as Pikmin. Alright. Pluck these purples. Now you might ask, why are there purples here all of a sudden? Well, these, as if purple Pikmin weren't overpowered enough, they are the only thing capable of taking down a Waterwraith. Waterwraiths are beings anchored in another dimension, and purple Pikmin apparently have the properties necessary to take them down somehow. So maybe purples have something not supernatural about them, but almost supernatural about them. Maybe. But there, whatever it is, it's going to help us here. Plus, we have Ultra Bitter Spray. Let's do this. Let's throw... Whoa! Okay, falls right on the egg. This time, instead of running from a Waterwraith, we're going to fight one. Oh, we got it. Got it. Whoa. It crushed a purple. We got it down to we got a quarter health down. Come on, bring it down. All right, that's enough. I don't want to gamble that. All right. At least now it knows it can be harmed. And now, throw a purple at it. Good shot. And this will be enough to take it down. Yes. All right. And now, its rollers are gone. And we get to see it for what it truly is. It gets out of shape quickly. All it can do now is run from us. And at the very sight of a purple Pikmin, it quails in fear. You have to wonder, if it's a being anchored in another dimension, what is it seeing? What are these purple Pikmin that we're throwing at it? What are they? Because clearly, they're enough for this thing to be terrified of them. Come on, that's enough. And swarm with the rest of the squad, let's kill it. Come on, kill it. And... Kill it. Yes, no, it's not dead yet. Now it is. Man, after all of me just commentating and yelling and not actually talking about what I'm really doing because I was so scared. Processing, how curious. The Wraith completely vanished, but what was it? Surface object scans indicate the presence of a bright red component. Now, I say this enemy was important for the end, or for the story of Pikmin 3. Now, I'm going to give, or the story of the entire series, I'm going to give a brief spoiler warning, because the story of Pikmin does actually have, besides the theories, there is something actually stated. The story of Pikmin 3 has a couple of almost supernatural elements to it. In Pikmin 1, we see the Smoky Prog, which isn't the final boss of the game. Is not the actual final boss of the game. But it has some supernatural properties that make it mysterious enough to give some thought to. And in this game, also, there it is. We just hit our Poku limit. With 16 to spare. Man, PalPlays did the math well. How insulting! This object's coloring is more eye-catching than my own hole! I shall connect it to the alarm to check our esteemed president... Or, the alarm clock our esteemed president was so fond of. Processing complete! I have refitted both objects into the pluckaphone! Now, simply blowing your whistle will inspire Pikmin sprouts to pop out of the ground! But the Smoky Prog, right? Supernatural-esque enemy. And in this game, we have the Waterwraith, which is a very unique entity. And it has some weird supernatural things to it as well. It's anchored in another dimension, and you can't hit it. You can't hurt it, except with one kind of Pikmin. And it's one of the few bosses that actually has a theme of its own, which is odd. There's only one other enemy in the game that has a theme of its own, and we haven't faced it thus far. And the final boss of Pikmin 3, once again, spoiler warning, is a form of Waterwraith. So there's something going on here, and I feel like it has something to do with the new... it backs up my theory of the nuclear fallout, because things being anchored in another dimension, that makes sense for some sort of nuclear anomaly. Alright. We've completed the cave, we've completed the debt. Now it's time to land on the surface. It's been a great adventure, guys. This has been an amazingly scary cave. I've been terrified in it. I was kind of worried that my childhood fear of the Waterwraith wouldn't crack up to be as much as I thought it would. But it was. The Waterwraith is scary, even to this day. And I lost a lot of Pikmin both to it and indirectly due to it because of the electric Dweevil. But now it's time to go to the surface and go back to Hokotate Freight now that we have amassed 10,000 Pokos worth of treasure. Let's go. And we leave the Bulbmen behind. We lost 66 Pikmin. By far, at least to my knowledge, that is the most amount of Pikmin we've ever lost. As in, that's more Pikmin than we've ever lost in the adventure thus far. We lost it in one cave. Partially due to difficulty, but also due to, I guess, some subconscious paralysis by my part. When I see the Waterwraith, I just don't quite know what to do. But I think I handled it fairly well. And overall, I'm proud of my performance. The Perplexing Pool. You've prepaid, or you've repaid the entire debt. Now to watch the game tank with a cutscene. Mission complete! You've earned 10,000 Pokos! Now Hokotate Freight will be prosperous and debt-free until the end of time, probably. Prepare to blast off! We return to Hokotate triumphantly! And that's it. That's Pikmin 2. Man. As I said at the beginning, every Let's Play I've made thus far, in the back of my mind I've told myself, I've excused it, saying that it was just one more game until I would play Pikmin 2. I was just one step closer. If originally, I was going to play this a year ago, but I didn't feel ready yet. And I'm so glad that I played it now. Being able to relive this part of my childhood, especially at the end of my childhood. I mean, I'm just about to start my last quarter of college. In fact, by the time this comes out, I will have already started my final quarter of college. And I'm glad that I was able to relive this portion of my childhood. This game meant a lot to me, and it still does. I remember 8-year-old Pal, upon first playing this game, first completing the debt, and seeing that cutscene, that was the first time I ever shed a tear for a video game. Yeah, a game with no spoken dialogue, a game with no real character development, had that big of an impact on me. And it's because it's a journey. Every step of the way, the story, is shaped by my actions, by the player's actions, every step of the way. is affected by the player. So by the end, there's an emotional investment in these characters, in this universe, because it feels so familiar. It feels like something we've seen before, and it is, because we see it every single day. Thank you so much for watching. I've enjoyed this series immensely, and I'm excited to bring you more content here on PalPlays. See you guys later. Days spent, 12. Pikmin lost in battle, 76. Pikmin left behind, none. Pikmin lost to fire and water, none. Pikmin lost to electricity, 31, all of which in that one cave. Pikmin lost to poison, none. Red Pikmin born, 208. Yellow Pikmin born, 150. Blues, 230. Whites, 60. Purple, 60. Total playtime, 8 hours. Really? That was unfortunate. Losing all those Pikmin to electricity, there was nothing I could have done. But still, I'm proud of this playthrough because you guys got to see it along with me. Resume the expedition and return to the planet? Yes? Let's down this. Apparently that happened. Whoa! Why? I was... No! Which is not normal for the recycles. Also, oh yeah, I forgot. Another thing. This area was also reused in Pikmin 3, I believe. If I can get a shot from this bluff... There was a river.